Welcome to part two of this mini-series explaining how erections come about. In part one, I explained the anatomical structures involved. Now it is time for hormones and to have a look at how the psyche influences the sexual response. My name is Stefan Buntrock. I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. If you like my content, give the video a thumbs up and subscribe to UroChannel. Sexual function is very complex. And one has to say that there are still lots of unanswered questions because of that. Especially what happens in the brain is far from understood. Much of what we know today is derived from animal studies. And there is one thing that you will always have to remember if someone is telling you about scientific results. Data from this type of research can't be automatically translated to humans. In humans, it may be different. With that said, let's have a look at the hormonal side of erections. The most important hormone is testosterone. It is produced in the testicles and the production is governed by the brain, telling the testicles to produce more or less, depending on the level of testosterone in the bloodstream. This is done by a special hormone by the name of LH or luteinizing hormone that is released by a small gland in the brain. Testosterone is important for the integrity of the penile tissues, but it is also of major importance for parasympathetic neurons, suggesting a complex neuronal activity. Testosterone is one of the main hormones for sexual desire in men, but also in women. Now, here's the thing. When we talk erections for sexual purposes, we will have to include the rest of the sexual response cycle, that is sexual desire, arousal, and orgasm ejaculation. Sexual desire is of utmost importance for erections. In clinical practice, I always ask my patients about these things. As it turns out, some of those who complain of erectile dysfunction have a lack of sexual desire. I mean, it's logical. If you don't feel like having sex, you will probably not get an erection. Although it is not entirely impossible, but sexual desire will help, and so does sexual arousal. So, what is sexual arousal? In contrast to sexual desire, it includes physical changes. Yes, also erections, but also things like blood pressure and breathing. There is no clear-cut definition of sexual arousal, but I think most of you have experienced it. Sexual desire and sexual arousal keep you focused. Things happen automatically then. Any form of anxiety will interfere with both and will most likely mess with your erectile ability. Hypogonadism, which is testosterone deficiency, will result in a lack of sexual desire. In most men, this is when testosterone falls below 8 nanomoles per liter, but this may vary quite a bit between individuals. It depends on the individual age, how fast the T levels drop, and many other things. A lot of men may get symptomatic below 12 nanomoles per liter. Hypogonadism will result in an increased death of smooth muscle within the corpora cavernosa of the penis, and in addition to that, there will be an accumulation of fat-containing cells in the penis. This development will impair the veno-occlusive mechanism of preventing venous blood from leaving the penis during erections. So, testosterone is a major player for erectile physiology. But there are other important hormones and neurotransmitters in the brain. I am talking about dopamine, serotonin, and oxytocin. Here it gets very complicated because there is an interplay of these substances together with testosterone involving different centers within the brain. There is promotion and inhibition at the same time, which makes it hard to understand. On a very general level, dopamine is a strong promoter of sexual desire. Oxytocin facilitates erections, and serotonin facilitates ejaculation. This is why selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors are used in lifelong premature ejaculation. Hormones exert a major impact upon the psyche, but the psyche is not all hormones. Technically speaking, for erections, you will have to switch on your parasympathetic nervous system using your psyche. Sexual desire and a state of arousal help with that, but you also need to be relaxed. any form of negative thoughts will activate the sympathetic nervous system. I am talking about performance anxiety, over-exaggerated expectations, all of that stuff. This will interfere with erections because the sympathetic nervous system, that's the flight or fight response. And if you want to run away, you can run faster without an erection. In my experience, this is especially a problem in young men. So much for the physiology of erections. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.